As you know, Pandas is king for data analysis. You can use it for data manipulation. The Pandas data frame is a two-dimensional data structure in Pandas. The good news is that you can leverage agents to interact with a Pandas data frame. Today, I'll show you how to use the Pandas data frame agent for question answering. Let's take a look at the topics we cover. First, we'll create a virtual environment and install the tools we'll use. Next, we'll initialize the LangSimit project to monitor the app, so we can trace the output. And then, we load a data frame. This data frame includes the population of the countries. After that, we'll create a Pandas data frame agent using the OpenAI chat model. Lastly, we'll chat with the data frame using this agent. Awesome! We've seen the topics we'll handle. Let's dive in. To write our code, let me go to the VS Code editor. What we're gonna do now is create a virtual environment. To do this, we're gonna use Conda. Let's write Conda create dash n let's name GenAI. I already created this. After that, we're gonna activate this environment. Conda activate GenAI. Here you go. Our environment is ready to use. The next step we're gonna do is install the tools we use. To do this, let's create a requirements.txt file. We're gonna click on the new file and then name it requirements.txt. After that, let's write the libraries we use here. We're gonna type langchain. After that, let's write langchain experimental to use the agent. And then let's type langchain underscore openai for the chat model we'll use. For loading the dataset, we're gonna leverage Pandas. Lastly, let's type python-env to get the environment variables. For now, these tools are enough to boot the app. We're gonna now install this. It's simple to do this with pip. Pip install-r requirements.txt. Here you go, our tools are ready to use. To write our code, we're gonna create a notebook. Let me click on the new file and then give a name. pandas.ipynb. Yeah, our file is ready. To select our kernel, let me click Python environments and then let's select GenAI. Let's go ahead and set environment variables. To do this, we're gonna use .env tool. First, let's create an env file. Let me click the new file and then name .env. Okay, our file is ready. Here, we're gonna type our environment variables. First, let's set the OpenAI API key. OpenAI API key. Let me paste the OpenAI API key. Next, let's set the LangChain API key. LangChain API key. This key helps us trace the outputs. You can get a LangChain API key for free from LangChain website. Let's paste the API key. After that, let's say LangChain tracing v2 equals true. Lastly, let's set the LangChain project name. LangChain project equals, let's give data analysis agents. Awesome! All we need to do now is load these variables with .env. First, let's import the load.env method. From .env import load.env. Next, let's use this method. Load.env. That's it. Variables are ready. It's simple, right? What we're gonna do now is load the dataset. The dataset we'll use includes the population of the countries. Let's load this dataset with Pandas. First, we're gonna import Pandas. Import Pandas as PD. Next, let's load the dataset with the readcsv method. Df equals pd.readcsv. Let's paste the dataset. Population.csv. Okay, we've loaded the dataset. Let's take a look at the first rows of the dataset. To do this, Let's write df, let's call the head method. There you go. You can see countries and populations. Let's go ahead and create our agent. The agent we're gonna use is the pandas data frame agent. This agent allows you to chat with your dataset. First, let's import this agent from LangChain experimental. Let's write agents. Let's call agent toolkit import create pandas data frame agent. Next, let's initialize this agent. Let's say agent equals create pandas data frame agent. First, let's set the model. The model we'll use is the OpenAI chat model. Let's import this model from LangChain OpenAI import chat OpenAI. Next, let's instantiate an object from this class chat OpenAI. After that, let's pass the temperature parameter to 0 for stable results. Temperature equals 0. And then let's pass the dataset df. To see the result in detail, let's set verbose equals true. Yeah, our agent is ready. Now it's time to chat with the dataset. Let's want to learn how many rows are there. To do this, let's write agent. Let's call the invoke method. Let's pass how many rows are there. Voila, our agent is running. You can see here how our agent thinks and the actions it took. Here is the thought. To find out how many rows are in the data frame, it used the shape attribute of the data frame. Here are action, action input, and final answer. The final answer returned as output. Our agent thought step by step and returned to the answer. It's cool, right? To trace the agent, let's go to the LangSmith website. Here is the LangSmith website. Click projects and then select our projects. There you go. Here you can see all the statistics, total tokens, cost, etc. Our agent executor is here. Here you can see information about your agent, such as input, output, start time, latency, tokens, cost, etc. It's nice, right? Let's click this. There you go. Here you can see the input and output. This way you can monitor your agent. Let's continue talking with our data. We're gonna use the invoke method again. Let's write agent. Let's call the invoke method. Let's say which countries have more than 1 billion population. Yeah, our agent is running. It's thinking to find the result. It's found India and China. Great. Let's go ahead and ask another question. Let's type agent. Let's call invoke. Let's pass. What is the square root of the average population? Yeah, our agent is running. It performed calculations to find the result. It's done. You can see the output here. To monitor outputs, let's look at the LangSmith. There you go. Here you can see the agents we run. Yeah, that's it. In this video, how to chat with a dataset using the pandas data frame agent. Note that the link to this notebook is in the description. Hope you enjoyed. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to subscribe, like the video, and leave a comment. See you in the next video. Bye for now.